Hello friends, welcome to TechTudes. In this video, we are going to implement bubble sort with animation. So first of all, let me introduce you with the bubble sort. So here is a Wikipedia page about bubble sort. And it is also called as a sinking sort and rabbits and turtles. This is one of the basic type of sorting in which sorting is performed with each and every element. So it has a complexity of n square, you can see here, time complexity of n square, because it compares to sort any element, it compares it with all other elements. So if there are n elements, then all the n elements have to be compared with all the other n minus 1 elements. So it has a time complexity of n square. And here is the pseudocode to implement this algorithm. And you can see here is the animation view. Let me tell a story about this bubble sort. Bubble sort is based on the concept that let's say we have a bucket full of water and we have bubbles in that bucket. Some are low weight bubbles and some are high weight bubble. So what happens is low weight bubble goes up and high weight bubble goes down, and in this way at the end all the bubble get sorted. So this is the theory behind bubble sort, and here is the pseudocode. So let's implement it, and we are going to use JavaScript library p5.js, which you can download from its website. This is the library from download page, and just download this file and include it in your folder. I'm going to use VS Code for editing purpose because it provides a lot of extensions. Which are helpful to me. So now I am in my Visual Studio Code and I have set up all the thing. Here is my index.html file. So let me show you how I generated this. As I am using VS Code, VS Code has an inbuilt extension emet, and to generate the HTML code, you just need to type exclamation mark and then press tab, and it will auto complete it. And let's replace this with bubble sort. So now we have this HTML page. We are using p5.js library, and we have a sketch.js, which is a blank file where we are going to write our JavaScript code. So first of all, let's include these two files in our index.html, sketch.js. So now we are ready. In VS Code, I'm using live server. So let me open with the live server so that I can see live effect. So now it is running, but it is blank because I don't have anything in sketch.js. So first of all, let me introduce you with the p5.js. p5.js works in two parts. First is setup function, and second is draw function. What we do is we write all the setup in setup, and whatever we want to repeat, we would write in draw function, because setup function is executed once and draw function is executed multiple number of times, and you can even define your number of frames in function setup as frame rate, and then R should be in capital, frame rate, and then specify frame rate whatever you want. For now I am going to use default one. So first of all, you can see here we are getting blank page, right? So first of all, let me create canvas for all the functions of p5.js. You can visit p5.js documentation, which is on p5.js page, And I'm going to create canvas of 400 cross 400. So now I have canvas, but it is not showing because it is default background of white color. So let's change it to black, 0. Yeah, so now you can see I have canvas here. So we are going to implement bubble sorts. So for that we will need points to sort. For that we are going to generate 400 points. So for I equals to 0 to I is less than 400 point, which is same as width. So let's say width. Width is field, inbuilt field of p5.js, which shows the width of a canvas. So you can access it by width. So now I am going to generate one variable, random values, which should be in the range of width, or you can write 400. Yeah, so now I have all the numbers. So let's draw it. Ellipse I comma y comma 10 10. What does it mean? It means that draw ellipse at position I comma y, that is x comma y. I am using I as x because it is varying from 0 to 400, that is 399, and I am drawing ellipse of the size 1000 cross 1000. You can see now all the points are plotted. But as we are going to sort all these points, we need to store this in an array. So let's define something here. I have not defined any of my variables, so let's define it here. I am using y, then I am going to use temp variable, and then I am going to use array input. So now I am generating my y values and I am storing it into input array by calling push function and giving it y values. So now you will not be able to see anything because I am pushing it into array. So let's console log to see values after all the values are pushed, and put. So let's inspect it and go to console, and here you can see array of 400 values. But you can see here that values are in double format, right, which we don't want. So let's change it to integer. Yeah, now all the values are first converted into integer and then it is pushed into input array. So now we have all the values set up. Now we want to sort it. Okay, so to sort, as we know, bubble sort compares the element which we want to sort with all the other elements. So we can type, so here what will happen, I is initialized with 0. Every time draw will be called, we will increment until I is less than 4, that is width minus 1. We are going to increment I plus I. Otherwise we don't want event to loop because looping will keep on. We don't want to loop after 400 iteration. Okay, so now we have our set. It will start incrementing I every time draw is executed, and it will stop once 400 loops are completed. Now let's write a logic for comparing with all the other element. So j equals to 0 to j is less than width minus I means to subtract all the sorted element. Let's say we have two sorted elements, so we don't want to compare with that elements. We want to compare with all the other elements. So j should start from 0 and go up to 400 minus I, and it should be incremented. And then we need to check if value, that is input at j, is greater than input at j plus 1, then what we want to do is we want to swap. So to swap, we are first going to store input at j into temp and then override it. In with input j plus 1 and then input j plus 1 equals to temp. So now we are done, but let's console log to see all the values. So as you can see, whenever I refresh this, save it again, and you can see here is a sorting happening. Let it get sorted. So now you can see here we have all the elements sorted: 1 1 2 2 6 7 7 9 12 13 13 14 16 18, right? But we are not able to see it on the screen because we have not draw any pixels which are get sorted. So let's draw that pixel. First of all, let's change fill color to let's say red, and then draw ellipse at position j and input of j 10 cross 10. So you can see what is happening. Yeah, you can say perfect, all the j elements are getting sorted as we are here swapping j and j plus 1 element, right? So we are going to print that elements, and let's draw ellipse at j plus 1 comma input at j plus 1 comma 10 comma 10. And now you can see we are done, all the elements are getting sorted. You can change frame rate, yep, from here. Let's have a frame rate of let's say 20. So now you can see frames are getting sorted. Let me show you in inspect how the elements are getting sorted. You can see here is 236, then 172, right? As 236 is greater, in the next iteration it will be swapped with 172. Now 172 is here and 154 is here, there, right? Next 154 will be 172 will be compared with 154, and as 172 is greater, 154 will come to 172 place and 172 will go to 154 place, right? So in this way sorting goes on, and at the end we get all the elements sorted. You can see it here. So this was all I wanted to show you, that you can draw animation of any of the algorithm. If you want to see exactly how it works, you can see this was the animation and we have implemented it here. And let's refresh this to see it again. Yes, sorted. Yeah, so this was all I wanted to share with you guys. If you like this video, press thumbs up down there and subscribe to TechTutes. And if you have any comments, or if you want any new algorithm to be implemented, comments down below. Thank you for watching this video.